Hello, I'm Amelia Earhart. I was born on July 24th, 1897, Atchison, Kansas. My parents are Amelia Otis Earhart and Samuel Stanton Earhart. My plane, the Canner Air Cirque, was a twin-engine, lockhead electric plane. When I flew my first airplane, I was 24 years old. Did you know I was the first woman to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean? Amazing, right? In addition to being a stellar aviatrix, I was also a lover and writer of poetry. You should remember me because I was the first woman pilot to fly across the Atlantic Ocean as a passenger, and later, the first woman to fly this route solo. I am a hero because I did what no other woman had dared to do. I made it easier for other women to go out and do things only men had done. I am a good role model because, I had the courage to do what no other woman had done before. And I was the 16th woman to receive a pilot's license from the FAI, license number 6017. The year I left on my last flight was on June 1st, 1937. I died in the Pacific Ocean. Some people think I lived 42 years. Thank you for letting me share my history with you. Oh, and if you think I am the best explorer, vote for me on Chrome.
Hi, I'm Henny Hutton, and I'm going to prove to you I am one of the most important explorers ever. I was born in England, September 12th, 1565. As a young lad, I am very curious, mostly about Asia. As I got older, I got more interested about Asia. Finally, I knew what I had to do. I had to go stop being curious and find out where the Northwest Passage was. After I knew what I had to do, I went to the King and Queen of England to see if they would give me a vessel. They gave me their blessing. I called the vessel the Half Moon. I set sail trying to find the passage. Sadly, I did not find the passage, and my crew was furious at me because we were sailing in the Arctic for so long, and we got stuck in the iceberg. So they put me on a little dinghy with some crew and sailed me off with 8 crew members and my son John off into the Arctic. But did that bring me to a standstill? No. But after a while, I could not hold on any longer. That means I died in 1611, and no one saw me again. But I did get a bridge, a river, and a statue named after me. The river is called the Hudson River. The bridge is called the Hudson Bridge, and the statue is called Henny Hudson, my name. I am the most important explorer ever because I will have many things named after me, and I was the one who found New York.
Hi, I am Samuel de Champlain. I think I'm the most important explorer because I helped colonize French North America, which is now called Canada. I was born in 1574 in Hiers-Bouage, France. I started my career as a soldier. After I was a soldier, I was a French explorer. My first exploration was in 1608. I discovered Lake Champlain and Quebec City, Canada. I went down the St. Lawrence River and people settled on it so it would be easier for us all to cross in the St. Lawrence River.
It's okay.
How old is the founded
city? It's okay, stop.
Hi, I'm Henry Hudson. I'm going to prove to you why I am the most important explorer in history. First, I was born in England in the year of 1565. I started my career as an explorer. My first voyage, I sailed for the country England in 1607. I was looking for the Northwest Passage to Asia. What I found was the Northwest Passage. Did you know my ship is called the Half Moon? My first voyage was in 1607. Did you know I was a sea captain? Then my crew put me on a boat and then I sailed into sea. I had 3 kids and their names were John, Richard, and Oliver. The most important thing about me is what I found, New York. That is the most important explorer ever, by Henry Hudson.